Hello and welcome, my friend. Here is the car doctor Peter Finn, and next I am planning to show you that how to install new gasket to car or truck brake caliper and brake calipers. And let's continue. Okay, and there is then this my brake caliper in here, that one what I am planning to repair and work with that area next. And this part opens so that there is two 12 millimeter bolts in that area, and next I open those bolts. And then I need to take this my brake caliper away, and again 14 millimeter bolt, and in that direction I open, and there's two bolts. First one in here, and second one in here, a little bit lower. And now they are open. And now I use my fingers. And let's look. There is first bolt. It looks like that. And then this lower bolt also in here. In that lower area. I take it also away. Very stuck part, and that's there is idea that when I take this firstly brake pads away, and then there is this brake piston, there is good chance that when I go to inside next to press car's brake pedal, then this brake piston, it came up, and it is easy to take away. Okay, and there is then this brake caliper, and now I go to press inside area again, and let's see that how much this brake caliper moves when I brake this brake pedal. And can we move that more? Okay, now it moves nicely, and then I need to press my brake pedal so far away that this part comes totally out, because then I can take this piston away. And actually now when I check that, it seems that this is actually enough away. Okay, and then I need this canister, because soon there is going out this brake fluid in that inner area. And now I take this brake piston away in that way. Okay, good. And then we can go to next step. Okay, and then I need to open that brake fluid bolt in here, and there is 12 millimeter socket, and also I need some canister, because brake fluid is draining out, and there is now a socket what size is 14 1/4 millimeters. And now I open this bolt is in here, and opening direction is in that way. Now it opens, and now I take that bolt away. It is in here, and this is brake fluid. And now we can see that there is this brake fluid bolt. It looks like that, and this is specific bolt. And keep, there is hole in inside, and keep that bolt clean. And then there is also fasteners, and those metallic gaskets in both sides. They looks actually in that one. This is this gasket area. There's a gasket. And now I insert this in secure place. And here is this brake fluid. And now there is no any brake fluid leak, because this my locking system keeps that in position. And then I have to install there some protective things in here, because this is sensitive part in here. Okay, and here is then this protective, this part, protect this my brake fluid hose, and then I install my hose in here, like a little bit away. Now it's in there, good. And then I need to take this my brake caliper away, and again 14 millimeter bolt, and in that direction I open, and there's two bolts. First one in here, and second one in here, a little bit lower. And now they are open, and now I use my fingers. And let's look, there is first bolt, it looks like that. And then this lower bolt also in here, in that lower area. I take it also away. And then I can take this my brake caliper. There's a second similar bolt in here. Okay, good. And now this brake caliper is loosened, but normally it is stuck, and I need next flathead screwdriver. Okay, and now I am cleaning this my brake caliper, this cylinder head area. And there is really a situation that I have to clean all of these inner areas and then these two holes. That hole, this inner hole and that outer hole totally clean, because I am next planning to install in there these new gaskets. First inner gasket and then outer gasket bolt. And then if I use my hook tool, I can clean this better in that way. And then when I have removed all of these dirties, I can do next job, what I is my in next step. Okay, and then I start to install these gaskets in there. And first gasket what I need to install is this this inner cylinder tube gasket, and this gasket goes nicely in the inner, so that I only little bit install that, and look, it must go in that direction, and be carefully that it is not in propeller, it must be in that shape, look, all areas, not in this way. If it is in wrong direction, then we have leak in the inner area. And now I install that in here. In that way. And then when I rotate that, it goes nicely. Okay, good. Okay, now it is in nicely, and then I check that all areas are in fine, looks good, everything is okay, excellent. And then I have to install in here this specific grease, and this is like specific, we have to purchase this rubber grease, and I have in here this, in this Toyota's grease, and then when I open that, this is grease what works well with these rubber those gaskets. Okay, and let's take that away in here a little bit. Okay, and it looks like that. And now I install this my grease in this black gasket. This is this purpose. Oh, all areas. And this is like lubricant. Okay, good. Let's look that. There is, okay, good. And then I need to install this grease also in this piston area, in that way. That this piston goes inner. I take a little bit more this grease. And in that area, what goes in their inner, there must be this grease. Okay, and also in that way, good. And then when I install this piston back, I have to keep this cylinder, brake cylinder in up that direction, and then carefully this part must be in 80 degree this position, and then I brake that side totally down, a little bit movement, and if everything goes nicely, yes, it goes nicely, excellent. And now this piston is in right position, excellent. And then I have to take this outer boot, but before of that I have to install in that area a little bit that grease also in here, this position, and then I can also little bit, I can rotate that brake piston in that way, but I can install all areas also in that area this grease. Good. Now we have all areas this grease, excellent. And then this part goes so that we have to look that this where is this upper area, this goes up, and then where are those holes, this goes down, like in that way. Now I install that. Firstly I have to install this inner part in there, that position, and then a little bit bending scratch, and this upper part goes nicely that hole, look, now it's in this hole, this is important, it must be in hole, and then I have only this lower part, and this lower part goes so that in I install that in this way, and in that step I take next workbench, because this is not good that this is moving in that way. Workbench helps me a lot. Okay, and then I start to install this brake pistons rubber boot, what is in there, that boot. And now I use also this workbench, and it is good to install this brake caliper in this workbench, because then it is much easier to handle this part. And now I just fasten that in here. Okay, good. And now we are in nice position. We can see this area in here. Okay, and now when I have installed this boot in there and a little bit grease, then my next step is to start install this lower part, this one, in that hole in here, what is in this down hole. And it so starts so that I start to press that in here, in this way, and it goes nicely. And all areas. And firstly with fingers, and I recommend to use some protective gloves, because this is really dirty job. And this part in here, this is the most difficult area in here, because there is difficult to insert fingers. But now I managed to do that quite well. And then I have to rotate this all areas, and also that area, and let's check that all sides are there deep in here, this is not, and in that purpose we can use some tool that we can press carefully these things in inner part, in this inner area. And now I check all areas that everything is fine. Okay, and now I notice that this area is not well in here. That area, in that area, and I press that in here and also in that side. And then if we have some hook tool, we can carefully also press. And this area in here down, this is the most critical. And when you install this back, please check that all areas are in here very deep. Okay, and now I believe that everything is fine in here, and then I take this new metallic, this locking pin, and it goes in. Idea is to insert in here firstly in that area, and then I compress that in, and I have to press that in down, and this metallic pin, it must go to this hole deep carefully in that way, good, in this way. Now it is enough deep, and then carefully I have to press that metallic pin in totally so deep that this is not right, this is too up, but when I press that in down, now it's better. Now this side, and this job is, and then of course carefully that I don't damage the boot. Because if I press that too hard, there are those dents in this. Okay, and here we can see that this is not nice in here. That side. And this takes time a little bit to press that in totally end in there. Okay, and now I press that carefully using my screwdriver, and let's look closer that can I install also these areas in here enough deep. Let's continue. Okay, and now I am using this flathead screwdriver, and I press that metallic pin in there deeper and deeper in all areas in here. Okay, now it goes nicely. Okay, good. Now I managed to install this metallic pin, and then next step is to take this my pliers, and then I need to rotate. I have to rotate this my piston carefully, only this up area, very small amount, and this is important that this our piston rotates that way. Excellent, everything looks nice, and then especially I can compress that in here, very good. Now everything is fine, and then this brake caliper, that one, this is ready for back installation. Excellent.